Hello, yes. This is RetroTK2, and today you'll learn all about arrays. We'll take a look at what an array is. Then we'll look at a single dimensional array. After that, we'll look at jagged arrays. And finally, we'll talk about multidimensional arrays and when to use them. If this is your first C# experience, I'd strongly suggest watching the series from the start. The card should be on your screen now. And if you haven't already, I'd advise downloading the channel files that accompany this video. Again, the card should be on your screen now. So let's get started. What is an array? According to the Microsoft docs, you can store multiple variables of the same type in an array data structure. You declare an array by specifying the type of its elements. An array has the following properties. An array can be single-dimensional, multidimensional, or jagged. The number of dimensions and the length of each dimension are established when the array instance is created. These values can't be changed during the lifetime of the instance. The default values of numeric array elements are set to 0, and reference elements are set to null. A jagged array is an array of arrays, and therefore its elements are reference types and are initialized to null. Arrays are zero-indexed. An array with n elements is indexed from 0 to n-1. Array elements can be of any type, including an array type. Array types are reference types derived from the abstract base type array. Since this type implements IEnumerable and IEnumerable of t, you can use for each iteration on all arrays in C#. Don't worry too much about that last point just yet, Ace. We'll go on to the topic of abstract classes and interfaces at some point in this series. Let's take a look at these in action. Open up Unity and create a basic C# script. As always, make sure you give your script a different name than any other class in your project. As we've just read, there are three types of arrays: single-dimensional, multidimensional, and jagged. We're going to take a look at single-dimensional first. To declare a single-dimensional array, we write out the type of the array first, int in this case is. Then we open and close our square brackets. After that, we have to give our array variable a name. When naming collections or arrays, it's usually good practice to name it the plural of whatever the array holds. Since this array holds ints, I'm simply going to call it ints. It could quite easily have been pigs, horses, or sheep, sis. Well, maybe not sheeps. Perhaps rams and ewes. Yeah, that'll do. Anyway, you get the idea. Now, much like all the other object initialization, we type out the new keyword, then type out int, and finally open and close our square brackets. As you can see, we get an error. Yes. Array creation must have array size or array initializer. Remember what the doc said. The number of dimensions and the length of each dimension are established when the array instance is created. Here I'm going to make our single dimensional array length 5. Okay, so we've just created a single dimensional array of length 5, but what does that actually mean? Well, it basically means that our array has 5 int elements. Each element has its own index in our array. If I want to access an element in our array, I type out the name of our array, open up our square brackets, and type out the index that we want. And of course, I close the square brackets too. One thing that might trip you up here is that our first element in our array is accessed using the index 0. So if I type out ints 1, I am actually accessing the second element in our array. Feel free to assign a new int value at this index is, or if you would like, you can treat the element like a standard int and do some calculations with it. All stuff that shouldn't be too hard to grasp is, but let's switch it up a bit. Let's try to access the sixth element at index 5. Save the script, head back into Unity, drag our script onto any game object in the scene, and run the game. And oh no, we hit an error. Index out of range, array index is out of range. Since our array has been initialized with a length of 5, we can only access elements within the range 0 to 4. Or, as the docs puts it, 0 to n-1, with n being the length of our array. You can find out the size of your array by accessing the length property. Type out the array's name, add a dot, and type out length. Save, head back into Unity, and rerun the game. And our length of 5 is logged. We can defend against the index out of range exception using this property is. If we check to see if the index is within the range of the array's length using the if statement if 5 less than ints.length, we will avoid the error. Save, head back into Unity, and rerun the game. And you'll see that we avoided the error, and we also haven't assigned the value of 1 to our element at index 5. Arrays can also be initialized with their values already set. Instead of declaring our array with a length, we can instead open our curly braces and declare the array with values directly. In fact, yes, we don't even need to type out new int open square bracket close square bracket. We just open our curly braces and add the values that way. This little trick only works if we have defined the type of our array, but we'll touch on that a bit later in the series. These values are separated by a comma, much like parameters of a method. The length of the array is determined by how many values we add initially. Here I've added 6 values, so our array's length is 6. The value of 1 is also assigned to the index 5, yes, since our if condition is met and the 6th element in our array is set to 1. Let's move on to jagged arrays. According to the Microsoft docs, a jagged array is an array whose elements are arrays. The elements of a jagged array can be of different dimensions and sizes. A jagged array is sometimes called an array of arrays. Okay, let's check these out. Here I'm declaring a jagged array of ints called jagged ints. What else would I call it? Initializing a jagged array can be a little trickier than a single dimensional one. You can use the curly braces only initialization method. Use the standard new int open square bracket close square bracket open square bracket close square bracket open curly brace close curly brace method, making sure to add more square brackets if you need arrays of arrays of arrays of arrays, or indeed arrays of arrays of arrays of arrays. Or type out new int open square bracket close square bracket open square bracket close square bracket with your length in the first square bracket. Again, adding more square brackets if you require multiple arrays of arrays. Here the array needs to know how big the first array is, but it doesn't need to know the length of the following arrays, since these are declared later. So, we've declared a jagged array with the first dimension's length being 5. What next? Well, we can access an element in an index between 0 and 4 like we did previously. Here our arrays are reference types, so unlike ints, the element's initial value will be null. We can of course assign a new value to our second element by using the single array initialization method we looked at earlier. So jagged ints at index 1 equals new open square bracket close square bracket open curly brace close curly brace and whatever values you'd like is. Unfortunately, we can't use the curly brace only shorthand initialization method here is. So now I can check the length property of the jagged array, the length of the array at index 1, and I can also access the value at 1, 1. Save, head back into Unity, and rerun the game. And hey, 5 is logged, 5 is logged, and so is 2. Jolly good is. Let's have a look at multidimensional arrays. To declare a multidimensional array, type out the type of the array, open your square brackets, and add a comma for each dimension you want. Here I'm creating a two-dimensional array, so I'm only going to add in one comma. Give it a name and type out the new keyword. Here we must specify how big the dimensions are. For this example, I'm going to make it 3x3. One very nice thing about multidimensional arrays is their syntax. While initializing, we can use the open curly braces method to initialize all the arrays. Since this is a multidimensional array, all the arrays have to be the exact same length, and we'll get an error if this is not the case. Array initializer length does not match the given size. To access a value at a given index, simply access it using the square brackets and type out the coordinates of the value. Here I'm getting the value at 0, 1. Getting the length of a dimension is a little bit more complex than simply accessing the length property. Instead, we have to use the getLength method and pass in the dimension we are looking for. Much like arrays, our dimensions start at 0. So the first dimension is 0 and the second is 1. If we go over the dimension of the limit and request the length of the third dimension at index 2, what do we expect to happen? Save, head back into Unity, and rerun. And you'll see we're hit with the index out of range exception. Now I know what you're thinking is, well, I prefer the syntax of the multidimensional arrays, so I'll definitely be using them over the Jagged ones. Well, apart from their syntax, what are the differences between the two? Well, according to Octane on Stack Overflow, or is that Octane? Apologies for butchering your name. Arrays of arrays, Jagged arrays, are faster than multidimensional arrays and can be used more effectively. Multidimensional arrays have nicer syntax. Then they go on to talk about IL code, which is so far beyond what we're talking about now, you wouldn't even believe it is. IL stands for Intermediate Language, and is the language C# is compiled to. We probably won't get onto the topic of IL for some time. The post continues to say, when using Jagged arrays, you can easily perform such operations as row swap and row resize. Maybe in some cases, usage of multidimensional arrays will be more safe, but even Microsoft FXCop tells that Jagged arrays should be used instead of multidimensional when you use it to analyze your projects. So should you use Jagged arrays and completely forget about multidimensional ones? Well, the syntax for multidimensionals is very nice. If performance is a big deal, and usually it is for game development, go with Jagged arrays. But if you can get away with it, choose multidimensional ones. This has been a quick introduction to arrays. Next time we'll see how to use these babies in loops. And that's it. Rate, comment, subscribe. I love hearing what you have to say. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with an array of questions. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.